BMS Institute of Technology and Management has a very vast, green and serene campus located in Yelahanka, which is close by to the Bangalore International Airport. BMSIT&M is a part of a proud group of institutions called BMS Group of Institutions, which is responsible for starting the first ever private engineering college in the country, and the college was BMS College of Engineering, Basurguri. We are so proud to be a sister institution of BMS College of Engineering here in Bangalore. The biggest strength of BMSIT&M is the highly innovative and effective teaching learning processes. Our institution has got state-of-the-art laboratories, academic as well as support infrastructure here. And we have a DST, Department of Science and Technology sponsored Advanced Materials Research Lab functioning. In fact, many institutions both in Karnataka as well as outside Karnataka are utilizing the services of these facilities here. We are practicing outcome-based education, which is of the order of the day in internationally reputed institutions. The idea here is to impart the kind of competencies and behaviors that are necessary in students to excel and solve the problems, complex engineering problems that may be there in the society as well as industry. Everybody who comes in contact with BMSIT, I'm sure they'll be relishing and enjoying their association with the institute here. You are most welcome to this institute at any point in time. Thank you.
BMS Institute of Technology as a member of the Departmental Advisory Board. After a round around the campus, departmental activities were presented for the board members. It was quite impressive. First of all, in the formation of the syllabus and the way of evaluating the students was very impressive in the sense that emphasis is given on the fundamentals rather than mug and reproduce. And the faculty members of the college, as per the presentation, are making a sincere effort to train their students in this regard. Going to the activities outside the so-called university syllabus, a spectrum of activities spanning from presentation capabilities to visiting an industry and looking at real-life problems have been covered. Apart from the classroom learning, the department seems to have taken several measures to improve the presentation capabilities of the students, one end, to understand and tackle real-life engineering problems.
And I currently work for a company called Palladian Networks, which is a pure-play information security company with presence in over 21 countries. My current role in the company is I'm the director of enterprise business and the head of our U.S. partner program. Over the last 7 to 8 years, Palladian Networks has been visiting BMSIT for recruitments. And I'd like to add that we've had an illustrious batch of alumni who are a part of our organization today.
I started up a new venture in my career after 3 years of working. Company which I've started called XN Robotics deals in industrial automation using robotics and PLCs. This venture, has been influenced tremendously by the program that I underwent in BMSIT. BMSIT kind of gives an environment, creates an environment which is free, lets you explore your creative side.
As a EEE alum, I think it's a matter of honor for me to come here and share my experiences. I truly believe that engineering for me was the building block or the foundation of who I am today. It helped me in three important ways. It gave me a very strong technical base. So even today when I want to get into a consulting role in the future, in terms of anything, say electric utilities or public services, I know that I have a very strong base thanks to the subjects that I learned. And it not just gave me technical education, it also gave me the opportunity to develop myself as a personality. For me,
BMSIT has been a great college to learn, to study, to bring yourself to speed, to learn about the new technologies. So I had this particular opportunity which was given to me when I was a student. I just started with being a security engineer, and now I have become a project manager in just a matter of 3 years.
It was a great support and an immense experience that we had, being it from the classroom point of view. We had various techniques of teaching, right, from classrooms and then PowerPoint presentations and poster makings, etc. And from the practical lab point of view, we had all the equipments that are required for all the the lab experiments we did.
Talking about the seminars and other activities which happened during our time, so there were national conferences that were organized based on wireless networks regarding telecommunications.
I am Abhishek Prakash and I graduated from BMSIT, the Department of Information Science and Engineering, from back in 2016, and I'm currently pursuing graduate studies in computer science at the University of Southern California.
Hi, my name is Prashant. I was the graduating batch of 2014 from the Information Science and Engineering Department. And I'm here to tell you a little bit about my department and how supportive the entire department has been so far in my undergrad education as well as my career. So the key points I actually have to tell you about is the main support which I received during my placement time and as well as the support and recommendation letters which I received during my when I was applying for my higher education. Even from the early years, once we joined the information science department, all the lecturers have been extremely supportive, clearly explaining all the concepts in the syllabus, helping us out with exams. Even during the lab sessions, they were constantly challenging us to come up with new ways to work on the same programs. And I've also had opportunities to write papers with my professors. I wrote a paper with my professor regarding my undergrad project.
Hey guys, my name is Afia and I'm from 2016 batch, and right now I'm studying in Australia, and that's the reason I can't meet you. So I'm doing my master's in Australia. One of the best things ISE department did for me was let me pursue my dreams, and since the first time they met me, they knew that I wanted to do higher studies, and the department has done their level best to make sure that I'm able to do what I want to, and they even provided me with some support where they were understanding to know which university I want to go to, and the research I did based on that, they tried to get feedbacks, and they were always ready to give references.
Our environment needs to be monitored in order to conserve it. So we started OpenCube Labs with the same machine back in 2014 in my college days with a couple of my friends. What we do at OpenCube Labs is like we try to monitor our locality with help of nanoscale satellites, and we make them using cans, the soda cans, and we call them CanSat. So a year after we founded OpenCube Labs, we thought like let's start spreading this across India to different colleges to bring in the space technology to the classroom. So
thank you. I request Shweta R, Electrical Department, to please step ahead. She's the gold medalist. Kavya Lakshmi Narayan Hegde.
It was the German poet Goethe who said, dare to dream and begin it. Boldness has genius, magic, and power to it. So you need to dream and dream big as you embark on this new education venture of yours in this sacred institution.
I would like to thank the parents for having reposed the confidence in this college by bringing and admitting all your students. Dear students, you will agree with me that listening to Captain Gopinath is inspirational. This is because his own life story is one of daunting all the odds, braving everything, and making a success of it. So it's very fitting that today, when you start your college years, you can listen to somebody like Captain Gopinath, and you can imbibe the essential lessons which he has set out.
Good evening to you all.
Thank you very much. It's my pleasure to welcome wonderful delegates from Czech Republic.
Some ambition. And the ambition would be to make your studies in the Czech Republic. And we will be discussing with the principal what we can eventually do together in order to find a good Czech counterpart, any of Czech technical universities that would eventually be willing to tie up with the BMS Institute of Technology.
prabhagan.